Hi, I'm Dan Schear. I'm sitting here in 2013, but for the grace of God, huh? Or the devil. I was reading this paper here from the Kentucky Enquirer. It's the Kentucky edition of the Cincinnati Enquirer from Sunday, April 29th of 2001. And as you can see, it says, bystander killed trying to help. What I learned that night, because I was at that place where this occurred, was that trying to help gets you killed. I did not help. I did not try to help. In fact, I hid behind a bass drum. We'll explain more on that later when I can. But I want to remember that night because, I think I want to remember it the way it was. I was eating a biscuit.
Hickok swears that he tried to stop you. He was scared that you'd shoot him, too.
He said you did it. All of it.
Sure. Now you'd like me to say he did it.
He's no killer, and he knows it.
That's why I picked you. He needed a trigger. You had nothing to lose. You'd already killed a man in Vegas. Beat him to death with a bicycle chain.
Tough boy. Real brass boy. Oh, I knew if we got caught. If he dropped his guts, he'd tell about that guy in Vegas. I never killed anybody. Not before that night. Was that night? No, I want to remember it the way it was. We got there around midnight. This is it. This is it. Let's pull out of here. Now, before it's too late. If you're gonna do it, you'll have to do it alone. You don't think I got the guts to do it alone? Okay, I'll show you who's wearing the pants. How'd you kill that guy in Vegas anyhow? Love him to death? Korean War hero. Cute.
Means more local coverage. Only on 9 News, your hometown news station.
Police and relatives are trying to figure out why a Northern Kentucky man killed himself and two other people outside a bar this morning. Police say 28-year-old Darrell White shot his wife and another man just after midnight outside the SandTrap bar on U.S. 27, just south of Alexandria. Channel 9's Janelle Walton spoke with some of the victim's relatives this morning.
Campbell County police say there were probably 30 people inside the SandTrap Bar and Lounge when the suspect shot two people around 12:30 this morning.
I need an ambulance at the SandTrap. I think I've just had a shooting in the parking lot.
Just had a shooting?
In the parking lot, yeah.
Okay, at the SandTrap outside.
28-year-old Darrell Keith White of Grant Slick, Kentucky, had already climbed into his blue tractor trailer by the time police arrived.
And the gunman looks in the bar and turns and goes towards the truck. I heard another pop when he gets in the truck and he shoots himself.
But police didn't know at the time if the suspect was still a threat.
The Newport SWAT team was called and responded to check the blue tractor trailer for the suspect. They entered the trailer and found that the suspect had indeed shot himself.
Police don't know why the suspect killed himself or his 22-year-old wife, Elizabeth. Relatives say the couple attended a wedding Friday night. 67-year-old John Hafer was trying to help Elizabeth when he was shot. This is a picture of Hafer taken about 40 years ago when he was in the Marine Corps. Relatives say he was always trying to help others. But it appears this time his offer for help cost him his life.
We seen her laying on the ground, and he turned around and said, somebody call 911. And about that time, pow, he shoots him in the head.
That was Janelle Walton reporting. Police are continuing to investigate those shootings.
You're watching 12 WKRC-TV, a new generation of news. 12 News at 6 starts now.
Police look for a motive after a triple killing shocks a small town in the tri-state. Good evening, I'm Paula Todi. A tri-state man opens fire in what seems to be a domestic dispute, but in the process takes the life of a man who only wanted to help. It happened just outside of Alexandria, Kentucky, early this morning. 12 News reporter Dennison Keller is live in the newsroom with more on this tragedy. Dennison?
Yeah, Paula, it's tragic on so many fronts. First of all, you had the young couple with kids going to a divorce, and that's sad enough. Then the husband kills the wife, leaving behind those two very young girls. Then on the other side, you have a 67-year-old man who's caught in the fire of a man he doesn't even know, and he leaves behind two daughters as well.
John Hafer survived 30 years in the Marine Corps and the Vietnam War, but a gunman's bullet finally caught up with him outside this bar south of Alexandria, just a few miles from his home.
I'm on the phone with the 911 now. There's two people dead at the front door. They just opened.
Right now.
After receiving that 911 call, police found that Keith White had shot his wife in the parking lot here. Hafer came out of the bar to see what was wrong, so White shot him too. Hafer's daughter said she's shocked by the killing, but not entirely surprised her father died the way he did.
If a friend of his called and said, hey, you know, I'm having problems, I need you to come down here and pick me up and take me here, or, you know, just anything. He would go out of his way to help, and he would even do it for strangers on the street.
After White killed Hafer, police say he climbed in his rig and then shot himself.
Campbell County police are still investigating this. They haven't said much really since this first happened overnight. We do know the two small children the whites leave behind are both under the age of 5 years old, and they're being watched now by relatives. Paula?
Well, Dennison, as we've already said, it looks like a domestic dispute, but what are police saying? Does it look like, do they have any motive for White doing this in the first place?
Well, the police aren't saying much, but the family says that Mr. White did want to get back together with his wife, and they were actually together on an outing last night. Obviously, they had some sort of disagreement that precipitated all of this. Paula?
All right, thanks a lot. Dennison Keller reporting live tonight.
So angry that he killed her.
He went to the bar, went back into the bar after he had left, and motioned for her to go outside and talk to him. And as soon as she got outside the door, then that's when he shot her.
Witnesses say White shot and killed John Hafer when he tried to help White's wife.
The guy went to the door and seen her. We seen her laying on the ground, and he turned around and said, somebody call 911. And about that time, pow, he shoots him in the head.
Campbell County police say White then shot and killed himself. Elizabeth's mother, Linda Turamey, cried as she thought about her only child's death. The 22-year-old mother left behind two daughters, 4-year-old Tara and 17-month-old Victoria.
She always had them outside playing with them. She taught them whatever she could.
Turamey says Tara was not Daryl White's biological child, but he did help raise her when he met her daughter 3 years ago. Turamey says her daughter had requested a divorce from the deceased suspect 2 weeks ago, but she's not sure if that had anything to do with the fatal shootings. In Campbell County, Kentucky, Janelle Walton, Channel 9 News.
Well, a memorial fund has been set up to help with funeral expenses for Elizabeth White. Contributions can be made in her name to the Bank of Kentucky.
Got there, and that's when I found out that my dad had been shot.
I just lost my brother, and then the fact that he killed two people in the process.
Tara Daly's brother, Keith White, is responsible for the killings. He shot his wife, Elizabeth, to death outside the SandTrap bar near Alexandria. Then he shot former Marine John Hafer, who had come outside to see what was wrong. Then Keith climbed in his rig and shot himself. Elizabeth's mother says her daughter gave her a prophetic warning the day before she died.
She says, "Ma, I'm afraid to be around him." And I said, "Elizabeth, what do you mean?" She says, "I'm scared of him anymore."
If it was a crime of passion, Keith had an awful lot of time to think about what he was doing. He left Elizabeth inside the sand trap, then came out to 27 and hitchhiked his way all the way back to his father's place. There he hopped on a motorcycle, drove a couple more miles to go get his rig. Once he got his rig, he then drove to his babysitter's place.
And talked to the kids, told them he loved them, kissed them goodbye, and went back to the bar, and I guess got her out of the bar and shot her.
Now that they know what happened, these families still don't know why, and they don't know how they'll handle it tomorrow, Sunday, a day for spending time with your family.
It's not gonna be normal. It's not gonna be a normal Sunday without knowing that I can go see my dad, because I'm not gonna be able to.
I just want God to forgive me for what I'm feeling of what he has done.
Keith's White family said they knew others would have this reaction toward their brother, and they said also they didn't want others to view him as a monster. They don't know what caused him to go off like he did, but they asked the other victims for forgiveness and said they are very sorry about what has happened. Paula?
So sad. And again, the innocent bystander, someone accustomed to trying to help out, I hear, right?
Exactly. He was a former Marine, a drill sergeant. He survived Vietnam War. It was his natural instinct. He heard what was going on, went outside to see what was happening, and boom, that's when he was killed.
Very sad. All right. Thanks a lot. Dennison Keller reporting live tonight.
Tonight, police are trying to figure out why a Northern Kentucky man shot and killed two people before turning the gun on himself. All this happened just after midnight at a bar south of Alexandria, Kentucky in Campbell County. Now, police tell us 28-year-old Daryl Keith White shot and killed his wife, Elizabeth, and another man who was trying to help her. Witnesses say White then took his own life. It all happened at the Sand Trap Bar and Lounge. Witnesses told relatives the gunman got upset when his wife beat him at a game of pool. The victim's mother says her daughter was planning on divorcing Keith White.